In this video, I teach you quantity governing method. So quantity governing method is generally used in petrol engine and gas engine. Petrol engine means it is also known as the spark ignition engines. So in this video, I teach you the construction, working, advantages and disadvantages of quantity governing methods, and also discuss the how the governing is done in a stationary engine as well as the moving engine. Means moving engine means in our bike or in our car. So here you see the figure of quantity governing that we discuss later on. First we understand what is the meaning of quantity governing. This method is also known as throttle governing. This method is generally used in petrol and gas engine. These methods varies the quantity of air fuel mixture supplied to the cylinders according to the load on the engine. Okay, in a quality governing, what we study, quality of the air plus fuel is changed, but in this case quality remains same, air fuel ratio is same, it is not changed, but the quantity supply of this mixture is changed. Quantity means, suppose in a engine we supplied the 0.5 kg per minute of the fuel mixture to the engine, and it is changed to 0.4, 0.6, 0.7, then it is known as the quantity governing. So as in place of air fuel ratio, in a case of quality governing, the quality of mixture is remain same, means air fuel ratio is same, just we change the thing, that is the quantity. So here in this image you see that this is the air and fuel mixture is coming from this portion. Okay, and this is a throttle valve, and this throttle valve is controlled by different things. So in a stationary engine, means stationary engine is generally used to produce the power for a home when the power is cut off. It is used in different farmhouse and in marriage functions where the electricity is not available. At that time we use the stationary engine. Okay, so in a stationary engine, to controlling the quantity, the governor is used. But in our bike and car, this governor, sorry, this throttle valve is controlled by using the accelerator. Okay, so in bike we increase the accelerator, the speed of the engine is increased, we reduce the accelerator, speed is reduced. So what happen when we increase the accelerator, at that time this throttle valve is open and the more quantity of the mixture is going and the power is produced more, and that's why our speed is increased. When we reduce the accelerator, then what, this throttle valve is closed. So quantity of mixture supplied to the engine is reduced. So engine produces the less power and speed of the engine is reduced. But in a stationary engine, we are not have accelerator pedal. That's why depending on the load, that is a governor is used, that we understand in the next part. So quantity of mixture supplied to the cylinder can be varied by throttling the mixture before it enters into the cylinder as shown in this figure. Means that is also known as the throttling, and this throttling is done by this throttle valve. This method of governing is generally used in stationary petrol and gas engine that's seen in this image. In automobile, the throttle is operated by using the accelerator pedal. In a car, it is known as the accelerator pedal, and in a bike we only call the accelerator. Before moving ahead, I request to like the video, subscribe the channels for watching the more video related to mechanical engineering, and also visit the playlist for watching the various video of mechanical engineering. So here I explain the working for a stationary engine. Okay, the movement of throttle valve is regulated by the lift of the centrifugal governor. Means this position of the throttle valve, means right now it is a more closed. So this throttle valve is come in the vertical position, that means it is totally open and more quantity is going. So we need to control the throttle valve, and this throttle valve position is controlled by using this governor. Okay, in a governor, that is a different different part, that is a fly ball and sleeves. Okay, so it is generally a centrifugal governor. The arrangement is shown in this figure. As the engine speed is increased, okay, when the engine speed is increased, when the load is increased, when the load is increased, when the few people is removed from the bike or car, or we move in a slope down area, okay, then what happen? The engine speed is increased, at that time the load is increased, and the governor ball fly out, means governor is moving at the higher speed. So when the speed is increased, the governor ball is try to move outside. That's why this arrow is indicate it is moving towards the outward sides. And the governor sleeve lift up. Okay, these fly ball are connected with the sleeve. So this sleeve is lifted up and the partial throttle valve is closed. Okay, then it is moved. So it is a link mechanism is there. So it closed this valve and reducing the quantity of mixer supplied to the engine cylinder. And opposite thing is same happen. When the engine speed is increased, and engine speed is increased when the load is increased. So flywheel speed is reduced, so it is moving near to the centers. Sleeve is moving downward direction and it's open the valve and more fuel is supplied to the engine. So this reduces the indicated mean effective pressure and ultimately the power developed by the engine. The system of governor can be used for gas engine in various way. So in a gas engine, the another method is also possible. In air and gas supplied, each can be throttled by separate valve. So in a gas engine, the air valve is different and gas valve is different. So it is known as the separate valve in air and gas passages and then supplied to the engine or a mixer of air and gas of constant air fuel ratio coming out from the mixing valve is supplied to the engine cylinders. The quantity of mixer supplied is controlled by varying the lift of a main inlet valve, or it is also controlled by varying the lift of the main inlet valve. Now what is the advantages of quantity governing? The ratio of air fuel mixer may be maintained constant for complete combustion. So complete combustion is takes place. Matter is so simple. What is the disadvantages? Throttling increase the suction pressure. So every time we do the throttling, so suction pressure is also changes every time. So throttling increase the suction pressure, which affect the combustion of fuel. Thermal efficiency increase due to efficient combustion. Next, limitation of each of the quality and quantity governing can be eliminated by combining these two methods. Limitation of each means quality as well as quantity governing can be eliminated by combining these two methods, and it is called as the combination method of governing. So thank you for watching this video. If you learned and like the video, subscribe the channels, comment on the video and also share with your friend.